Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on what is engine knock and some common causes of engines knocking. Engine knock occurs when combustion does not originate from the propagation of the flame front as ignited by the spark plug. I know that sounds a little confusing. That's just the quick one sentence definition of detonation. Detonation is the actual phenomenon that is occurring when people talk about engine knock. However, when detonation occurs, the engine makes a knocking or pinging sound. As such, many refer to detonation simply as knock, knocking, ping, or pinging, which more specifically refers to these sounds, but again, are very common words to talk about detonation in engines. Now, in order to properly talk about detonation and engine knock and what is occurring when detonation happens, it's important to talk about the combustion process and talk about what a normal combustion process should look like. Ultimately, during the engine's compression stroke, as the piston is nearing top dead center, the spark plug will ignite the air-fuel mixture. And when an engine actually ignites the air-fuel mixture, it isn't a sudden, violent explosion or detonation. It's actually a very controlled burn. So that spark plug ignites that one pocket of the air fuel mixture. And at that point, the flame front should start propagating and smoothly moving throughout the cylinder and gradually ignite the air fuel mixture. And so when that gradual process occurs, it's very smooth. It leads to a very smooth, clean combustion process. That's really the important note, is when thinking about combustion, it's not some big violent explosion of the entire air fuel mixture at one point in time. So that's what gives you the nice smooth combustion and really how an engine should work. However, in some cases, engines detonate. When an engine detonates, that refers to essentially a pocket of the air fuel mixture igniting that didn't stem from the flame front that was ignited by the spark plug. So unlike the standard combustion process, which is again very smooth and a controlled burn, detonation is not. When part of that air fuel mixture ignites when it is not supposed to, it's a much more violent detonation, very much more like an explosion. And so when detonation occurs, that is going to send a shockwave throughout the cylinder. It's going to suddenly spike cylinder pressures and temperatures drastically. It is that shockwave that actually, as it contacts all of the metal surfaces, that's actually what creates the knocking or pinging sound, almost kind of like a hammer tapping on a metal object or something of the like. So that's where the terms knocking and pinging stem from, is really that sound as the shockwave from the detonation event comes in contact with the metal. And so all of that is very bad for operation, mechanical strength, and longevity of the engine. Engine knock and detonation is something that all engines should be designed to tolerate some additional abuse and some detonation. Ultimately, almost every engine on the road, especially those that make it to 150, 200,000 plus miles, are going to experience detonation probably at least a few times throughout the course of their lives. Most engines are designed and capable of handling some minor detonation events. However, when it is allowed to happen for the long term, that can take a serious toll on the engine's wear and tear and longevity. If you talk about more serious detonation events, especially on higher performance engines or engines that are really pushing their upper design limits, this is where you start to see pretty drastic engine failures, especially on boosted applications where you're running very high cylinder pressures, higher temperatures. That's where you can start to see very severe detonation events taking out an engine in a matter of seconds or even less than that. And when pistons can completely break in half or rods can bend, metal parts can get thrown through the engine block. So ultimately, mild detonation in the long term isn't likely to cause any sudden drastic engine failure, but it does reduce longevity. And in the cases of more severe detonation events, that can completely kill an engine in a matter of seconds. Detonation is a very serious thing and something to be aware of if you are experiencing issues with detonation. It's something that should be addressed and fixed as soon as possible on your vehicle. So with that said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss some of the most common causes of engines knocking. Some of the top causes would be too much ignition advance, so essentially igniting the air-fuel mixture when the piston is still too far from top dead center. So being too aggressive with your engine engine's ignition advance can cause problems with knocking and detonation. Another common cause is your fuel's octane rating is too low for the specific setup. So when you look at factory cars, manufacturers design cars with all of these things in mind. And so as long as you're running the recommended fuel, you shouldn't have an issue. But fuel octane rating is something that really comes into play, especially when tuning and modifying vehicles. If you are increasing boost pressure, changing the ignition advance, and a bunch of other parameters, it is important to make sure you have the proper quality fuel for those adjustments that you have made to the tune and modifications on the vehicle. Much less common, a bad tank of fuel can also cause the same. Again, not very common to run into, so oftentimes it's just poor octane rating for your specific vehicle or setup. Having a lean air fuel ratio, so essentially not enough fuel in the cylinder. The less fuel you have in the cylinder, the hotter that cylinder is going to run, and also the greater chance of detonation simply because there isn't as much fluid, there isn't as much fuel actually filling the cylinder. So lean air fuel ratios are a major cause of detonation and something to really be on the lookout for. Very important to make sure that your engine is not running too lean, especially if you are tuning and modifying the engine and pushing the limits a little bit further on the engine. Another major cause of engine detonation can be cylinder pressures that are too high. Cylinder pressures can't be modified all that easily on a naturally aspirated engine. However, on boosted engines, this can be changed very drastically. Looking at examples of a lot of cars which are able to run 1.5x or maybe even double the stock boost with the stock hardware. Another common cause is going to be the engine load being too high. And last but not least, the cylinder temperatures being too hot. So it is actually a lot more common for engines to experience detonation in a warmer climate. Cooler air is going to be more resistant to detonation, and so a cooler climate is really going to help aid and prevent against any detonation events occurring. So with all these common causes out of the way, looking at a few ways on how to prevent engine detonation. Number one, increase your octane rating. This is why a lot of higher performance engines will often move away from pump fuels. Even 93 octane in the performance world is seen as a pretty poor fuel quality and low grade fuel. And so this is why you'll see a lot of higher performance engines running things like ethanol or E85, methanol, race gas, which is fuel, but much higher octane, often 100 plus octane rated fuel. So ultimately increasing that octane rating via these fueling options is a great way to help prevent against engine detonation and something that can be incredibly important depending on your specific vehicle and setup, if you're tuning and modifying it. Another great way to help prevent detonation is retarding the ignition timing. So again, if your ignition advance is too aggressive, that can cause detonation. So pulling out a couple degrees of timing can help prevent against the engine knocking. Richening the air fuel ratio of the engine can help prevent detonation. So just injecting a little bit more fuel into the cylinders relative to the amount of air. For boosted applications, decreasing the boost pressure can help lower cylinder temperatures and cylinder pressures. So that's a good option for boosted engines. If you're running into detonation issues, it might be the fact that you're running too much boost and just too much pressure for your specific ignition timing, fueling, so on and so forth. Another great option to prevent detonation is by cooling your intake air temperature. And so this is a big reason things like nitrous or NOS can offer so much power, is that greatly reduces the temperature of the intake charge. And again, ultimately just cooler air, a cooler cylinder temperature is going to help prevent against detonation. And that's a reason too that water injection can be very popular on boosted engines. Even just injecting a little bit of water into the engine can help cool it a little bit. And just having that additional humidity makes it less likely that a pocket of that air fuel mixture is going to spontaneously detonate out of nowhere. Anyway, that wraps up our video for today. If you guys appreciated the content, please hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more. Thanks, everyone.